Shit. I know it usually take a little minute to get some folks up in here, then we start working. Let's see. Let me let my people know we are live right now on YouTube. One moment, please. Yo.
What you coming with? The army is doing something.
Yo. I'm just letting all my people know we live right now. Y'all stay patient with me. We back. I'm just letting my people know we live on here. What's going on? I'm just getting my people up in here. Okay, we back, man. Shit, what's going on? You know, I'm still working on this masterpiece right here. this shit is not easy work. People be thinking I just be doing this shit like it's nothing. Like it's not time consuming. This shit's fucking time consuming like a motherfucker. Let's see where I'm on right now. So you just fucking with this wilder images. I gotta like, you know, blend the colors in a little bit better. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, let me hit it with another layer. What's popping, Michael Johnson? What's popping? Hold on, y'all. You know, I'm just working right now. Anybody can join. I'm not doing shit, but just working. So I seen Hot Cheek King hoodie, fam. You sell more of them? You know, man, I haven't put nothing, no hoodies on the website yet. I've just been chilling because I'm like, dude, it's hot as hell. But I guess people still want hoodies. So I just got to take a time out of my day and just update my website or whatever. But best believe they're coming, man. They coming. Even the Fury fans, they looking like, man, why is Artman selling? He's selling hoodies of Tyson Fury in a casket, man. Fuck Tyson Fury, man. Real shit. Fuck Tyson Fury. Says, shit, I just got out of football practice beating up the DBs. Shit, man, I haven't played football in a long ass time, dude. Man, that shit, man, I haven't played football in a long time. I used to be good, man, back in the day. But you know what happens, you know, when you start, when you're a young dude, you get in high school, you know, when the ladies start coming around, shit, you like, I ain't trying to play no more football. I'm trying to see where the chicks at. And that's exactly what I did. I even dropped artwork to go follow some chicks and smoke a lot of weed, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, always take my hat off to people that's in sports is actually staying healthy, man. Too many fucking motherfuckers out here just love being comfortable and lazy. As long as you're doing something, that's very positive, man. Said, facts, fuck Fury, bro. Said, yeah, fuck them guys, man. Real shit. Real shit, fuck those guys. Hold on, let me play some music, man. I got a whole bunch of shit going on. Whole bunch of shit, man. I don't even know if I'm going to get banned from YouTube for doing this shit, but fuck it. This is for promotional use only. I'm not out here. Look, all the shit I'm listening to. Hold on. Who do I feel like listening to? I'm listening to my nigga Currency. Shit, you know, I gotta roll me up one. Get this art session really cracking. But what's on your mind? What's popping, yo? What's popping, man? How's life, dude? How's life knowing that fucking Tyson Fury is not fighting Deontay Wilder on Saturday like we fucking planned? That shit still pisses me off. Like, what the fuck? Like, and Fury fans still talking shit. Shit, what Fury do now? It's what he's gonna do, man. Hold on. Let me play that video. Let me play that video real quick while I roll up. Look at this shit. Somebody send me this.
I'm boxing on top, undefeated, and don't give him me three much. Look. Every day I wake up's different. Some days I think like retire from boxing on top, undefeated, and don't give him me three much. Yeah, make him suffer that way. And other days I think, yeah, I'll fight him and knock him out. Other days I think, yeah, I'll fight him and take a dive. Other days I don't know what I'm going to do. And this is the truth. I ain't lying. I'm pouring it all out to you. Just so everything's on the table. You know what to expect on the night. Every day I wake up's different. Some days I'll think like retire from boxing on top, undefeated, and don't give him me three much. Yeah? Make him suffer that way. And other days I think, yeah, I'll fight him and knock him out. Other days I think, yeah, I'll fight him and take a dive. Other days I don't know what I'm going to do.
Man, bro, I don't know if you guys heard that, but the motherfucker said some days he feels like just retiring undefeated so he will suffer and not give, by not giving him his rematch, he's going to suffer. Like, what type of bullshit is that? And then I'm sitting back thinking, like, what the f-? Say, yeah, I remember that bit, and I remember when he was running and jacked his ankle up after saying he might do it. Yeah. I mean, I wish Andre Ward seen the red flags in Tyson Fury. The same red flags he's seen in Wilder fucking putting his headphones on. Because, man, to be honest, dude, I'm going to keep it 100 with you guys. I really didn't know nothing about Fury until Deontay Wilder said, I'm going to fight him. I really didn't know shit about Fury. All I thought it was this giant white dude that says that he was, you know, had the balls to step up to Wilder. That's it. I didn't think that this motherfucker was a crook. I didn't know nothing about this shit, dude. I wish I'd known this motherfucker was like this, dude. I really did. I wish I knew Tyson Fury was like the way he is, man. Shit's just crazy, dude. But, you know, it's like, what's concerning me now is now his Tyson Fury's father is starting to get confidence again. He's saying crazy things about Wilder again. And I'm like, oh, shit. That means Tyson Fury might be on the pits this go around again. Because why would his father gain, why does his father gain confidence knowing that he's going back to the UK now? Stuff like that makes you ask questions. Questions that Tyson Fury fans and Andre Ward and all, it's not going to ask. Like, why are you confident all of a sudden? At first, you're saying that, man, your son fuck around and get beat. But now you're confident again? To me, it sounds like y'all got a little plan going on. But, you know, it's all good because this time around, as long as Wilder's not inebriated, I think even if Fury tries to go in there on some funny shit, he's still going to get his ass laid the fuck out. Real shit. I think he's still going to get laid the fuck out trying to do some funny shit. Like, where did that come from? Where did that confidence come from, man? Where'd it come from? Said John Fury saying that because they finna find a master plan of cheating. Shit like he did with that 100K bet. Yeah, it's like, where did you, like, where did this come from? Where did this surge of energy come from? You was just saying you fear for your son. You fear for your son thinking that he gonna get robbed over here. He's still coming back to fight over here. So what's changed? Oh, I know what's changed. Y'all got a grand plan. But this time it's not going to work. This time it's not going to work. Because all eyes is on this motherfucker like a Tupac album. All eyes are on you, bro. And we going to see. All that shit you talking, we going to see. All that shoot 'em up shit you talking, we trying to see it. Real shit, man. Hold on. How y'all feeling, man? Let me know. What y'all think? Y'all think Tyson Fury gonna show up? Yes or no, man? Y'all let me know in the chat. Y'all think Tyson Fury gonna show up? I don't think he's showing up. I definitely don't think he's showing up. But you gotta think about it. That is a big-ass lawsuit if he don't show up. Ooh. How he gonna deal with that? Who's gonna pay for that if he don't show up? Man, Top Rank gonna be looking so crazy if he don't show up. Like, how do you, even if you got Mike Coppinger as your fucking star writer now, how the fuck is he, you guys gonna explain to the public that Tyson Fury just gypped a whole bunch of fans? How? Because they already struggling to put this COVID story down the line. Like, we looking at this shit like, dude, the fuck out of here with this damn COVID shit. You don't got no damn COVID, Tyson Fury. Stop playing games, man. Like, man, before I even get started, let me light this fucking Tyson Fury pack up. Said, I think he's showing up, but nobody should rule out he won't pull out. You know what I feel like sometimes? Sometimes I be pinching myself because I'm like, dude, it was too good to be true. It was too good to be true that this motherfucker was going to show up in July. Because I swear to God, it's like the fight just That was pretty fast, if you ask me. Don't y'all think that was pretty fast? Like, May 17th, they got the decision from the arbitrator. Now, July 24th, they fight him. That was fast, dude. So, you know, now I'm thinking like, yeah, man. I should have known something was up. Say, I think he's showing up. What if he don't show up? Today, I said on my Twitter and Instagram, I said, man, if I was Deontay Wilder, I would have my lawyer on standby, and I have a replacement opponent on standby. Real shit. Fuck Tyson Fury. But man, what did they like do? Now I'm thinking like, y'all really got me sitting here thinking like, dude, what if they do show up? What if Tyson Fury do show up trying to put on his best cheating performance? I mean, I don't think it gets any better than what he did in that last fight. Like, that was some like, that was definitely some bullshit. Yo.
Oh, what it do? What it do? It's Mike. Mike Johnson.
Man, I definitely thought you was about to be somebody else for a second.
Nah, I just be my thing gonna be popping up because I be using Google Chrome on my phone, so my icon don't be showing up. I gotta log back in the StreamYard on Google Chrome.
Oh, okay. Shit, how you feeling today, bro?
Shit, I'm feeling alright. Beat them DBs up at practice. You know, not the DBs, wide receivers. I keep switching up. They just play wide receivers.
Okay.
But other than that, man, I'm feeling good, man. I can't wait to see the fight this weekend. The
Wilder versus Fury fight? Shit, me too. What, you ready to see that Carlos Taco versus Joe Joyce?
Yeah, I want to see what that old man gonna do.
Joe Joyce gonna knock that motherfucker out.
I don't know, but have you seen the clips of Carlos Takam?
I haven't seen no clips of Tom.
Because nobody wanted to show him.
What he looking like now?
He looking like, I mean, the dude, to Carlos Takam's problem is that he kept taking fights on last minute. Like, you know what I'm saying? Last minute notice and stuff.
He do be taking fights on short notice. I noticed.
Yeah, that. He did it with Anthony Joshua. Look how he did. And I don't think the fight should have been stopped.
Me either. I was just talking about that fight. Do you remember that? You remember that fight? Because a lot of people don't remember that.
Man, everybody, a lot of people I know, even people in the UK, was just like, what the fuck? And it was kind of like the commentators in that fight was even kind of in on it, like saying, it's like, boy, he's losing every round and blah, 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 blah. But that's fucking boxing. You know what I'm saying? It's like,
that's heavyweight boxing at that.
Yeah, and you just taking the fight away from a person because you're feeling saying this, that, and the third, but that's not your fucking plate. Like, yeah, it's safety and all that stuff, but boxing ain't safe no way, no shape, form, or period. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, you know what I remember about that fight too?
Yeah, go ahead.
I remember that they gave AJ a special timeout in that fight.
Oh, yeah, he did.
You remember
that? They always hook him up. It's kind of like they scared to have somebody put the gas on them because they scared they might get fired and not have another.
Yeah, they don't fight. They want a payday, man. They don't want to lose. I learned the game now, dude. I definitely did. These people, they don't want to lose the relationships with these fights because they don't want to get their credentials shit taken away and all that. So they just play they play it safe.
And they keep having the same refs. The same lazy-ass, old-ass refs come up, I mean, judges come up in there, and over again, they fucked up. Lance Pugmire, he even put on his Twitter, like, what can the fuck we do about this? Like, I wrote on there, like, nigga, you got the resources. You got more resources than anybody to do this job. You know, and I said, told him, it's like, you know, you got arrests from different commissions in that fight. It's like, if the commission is getting paid by the state, the commission has to hear what the public have to say. Because those minutes are doing normal minutes that the state is publishing. Whether or not it has to do with the budget or whatever the case may be, they have to present their numbers in front of the public. And what they've been making. And, you know, you go to Nevada State Athletic Commission website, you can see when they're about to have their next schedule. And you're going to tell me you have all this resources, but ain't using them. You got contacts. You got people that can get you there. You got the money to take the flight there. You know what I'm saying? You got people that can get you in contact with these dudes to talk about these things when it comes to these wrestling judges, but they don't want to. They don't want to do it. They don't want to ruffle feathers like that. They want, like you said, they want that job. Yep. They're trying to get paid.
They willing to turn a blind eye, because let's be real, just because a lot of people not speaking out on it, that don't mean they don't believe Fury cheated, man. I'm telling you, everybody in the boxing industry, they all don't think Fury did cheat, but they trying to perceive it that way. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, think about it. You think everybody in the industry think Wilder didn't get cheated?
I put it to you like this. You know you own a something, right?
Yeah.
This is how you know that you own a something. I'm over here cooking in the kitchen some yellow squash and shit.
Go ahead.
You know you own a something at least, right? At minimum. When somebody fucking tell you, those gloves look fucking funny. The fuck you mean they look funny? We all been told, where there's smoke, there's motherfucking fire. What the fuck you mean they look funny? You know you own it something when people say shit like that. Because at the end of the day, if they didn't look funny, if they didn't look funny, right, then there's nothing wrong with it. But if they look funny, ain't there doubt?
Yeah.
Ain't there doubt there's something wrong with them?
Yep.
You know, that's one thing I'll be saying about these dudes. Like let's keep it real, right? Let's keep it real. Let's keep it consistent, right? Everybody want to talk the WBC and all these sanctioning bodies and shit like that. Want to talk about safety and all that shit, right? They want to talk about fighter safety and all that shit, and don't bat an eye when it comes to this, and don't have a comprehensive definition on what a boxing glove is supposed to consist of. They don't. They tell you which gloves is that you could just buy, right? They already got the ones that's already approved. Yeah, they still got to inspect them, right? But they already got the ones that's already approved. Like, you get them, they wrap them up, they get sent to whatever, and they get locked up, right?
But they say, but Sugar Hill's on tape saying he got that shit at his house.
Yeah. Oh, and he probably, yeah, you know what? I wouldn't doubt he don't. I wouldn't doubt it. He probably showed up, dude. He probably already went back and looked at him after he said that on that live stream, and he shook his head but said, fuck it.
Fuck it. I gotta ride this one out. I gotta ride the I don't know what happened out, route out.
You know? And like I said, with the comprehensive thing with the glove, like, the only thing that's gonna tell you what a boxing glove consists on really is they pack. That's it. You go on any website, WBC, any of these boxing commissions website, they're not gonna tell you how much padding is supposed to be on the knuckle area. They're not gonna tell you how much padding gotta be on the wrist area. They're not gonna tell you how much padding gotta be on the backside area, because not everybody's hands in the heavyweight division are the same size. Somebody fit in the medium, somebody fit in a large, an extra large, 2X, 3X, but they all supposed to weigh the same, right?
And even though it's supposed to weigh the same, that don't mean somebody couldn't distribute it a certain way. Like, come on, like.
But it has to be distributed a certain way.
Saying, like, if, blood, yeah, it has to be. But I'm pretty sure if niggas been doing this shit for 100 years, I'm pretty sure they know how to distribute the padding in the gloves to where they want it to still weigh the same and have that little extra oomph.
They with, do a period because that's yeah. they do a period because yeah. what a therapeutic glove.
Yeah.
But, you know? Okay,
but I always ask this. So let's say you were in this predicament, right? You just got knocked the dude out by 7-round stoppage. Or you ain't knock him out, his team threw in the towel. And then he accused you of having tampered gloves. Wouldn't you show the world your gloves just to prove everybody wrong? Like, man, what the fuck are you talking about? These regular-ass gloves.
I mean, it depends on who you're talking to, right?
Yeah, I'm
because saying some people would want to vindicate themselves, but Tyson Fury's one of them. He's one of them no comment guys. When the block get hot, he won't talk to you. That's the reason why when Tyson Fury talks and stuff like that, those are approved interviews. He's not talking to anybody straight off the street. You know what I'm saying? He doing approved interviews. You know what I'm saying? And
he got Elliot out there.
Yeah.
Out of that damn room. He said, oh, get him out of here.
Yeah. Interview's over. Interview's over. You know what I'm saying? Like, dude, we know. Everybody know. Like, whether smoke this fire, you have literally no consistency with nobody, and even your own fans is doubting.
Yep, now they starting to look like Dan. At this, dude, I still remember, bro, how I went on Twitter. It literally went on Twitter from, like, everybody just doubting me, calling me crazy, to damn, what he about to say next? Fuck. Because Tyson Fury just keeps on showing out. The fact that I was able to expose that on Twitter with him at the exotic car dealership, man, that killed them right there, because they really have no rebuttal for that, because it's like, wow, this guy is really that bold with it.
Yeah. And if you was in, I highly doubt they'd do it, but where's the investigative journalism? Like, okay, you're not gonna go there and try to get the tape or get a copy of the tape. Y'all motherfuckers always out there quick. Look, this is the crazy thing about it. When these black athletes get into scuffles and shit like that with the domestic violence and shit, right? Or get pulled over on the side of the road or something like that, how come they always got the tape like quick, fast, in a motherfucking hurry? Audio and everything. Ben Roethlisberger, the white dude that beat the black woman, the office of defensive lineman or whatever, yeah. Where's those tapes at? Where's those mugshots at?
That story got buried.
But when it comes to everybody else, whether that is Tank Davis, because they got people's cell phone videos and they got the security cameras. But when it comes to Shakur Stevenson at a damn gas station, he got the tape quick. When it comes to all these other cats, they got the 911 audio and everything quick, fast, in a hurry. So where is this investigative journalism and that same effort when it comes to Tyson Fury?
There is none.
How come y'all ain't got the video of him walking around maskless, you know, and even insinuating was Tyson Fury shopping while he should have been quarantined? Because now, if they do that, they know the authorities got to get involved.
Because it's like, what is he doing? So you telling me this man is sick? He's out here mingling? This is your employee and he out here sick, mingling.
And you know he always touching his nose and sniffing. So he's spreading it, for sure.
So he doing all that, and they acting like, see? And then that's, you know, it's true. Said, dope artwork. Thank you, man. I'm just working, man. It's gonna be look. It's gonna look real nice on the hoodie. I can't wait, dude. You know what would you do if you was wilder in the situation? Like, what would you do?
Like I said, like I would already have a private investigator on deck.
Yeah,
watching. I'll have. I can't just rely on. I can't just rely on people that I know. Working in his camp and stuff like that. I got to have somebody in an official capacity on payroll, literally watching this guy. I don't give a fuck if he's taking the shit. I want to know who he's been hanging around with. I want to know what he's been doing, what he's been moving. I want to know if people that's been going into the gym, did they have day tests? Did they try to quarantine him? Was they following them? Was they following proper guidelines? What were the proper guidelines at the time? You know, I would want this motherfucker to prove to me that he wants to fight. And when you catch COVID, because you're probably allowing every swinging dick into your motherfucking gym because you clout chasing, you want to take all these damn cameos. You know what I'm saying? And try to make your name by yourself for that, right? What was you? Was you putting yourself in harm's risk? Was you making sure that the guys that came to your gym at least showed up with a negative test? Did you tell these guys that they can't do this and do that and make them sign something? So if they was the ones that happened to bring it into the gym, you know who did it? Did you? Highly doubt it. Highly think he gave a fuck by his track record.
And all that shit's documented. The fact that his track record shows that he's like this, where he's irresponsible and he's a loose... Bro, I swear to God, I never even seen that Theory video until, like, just now. Until I just posted it.
I think that's the same video where he says that. Where he says, I just might trip and sprain my ankle.
It could be. I ain't watching...
That's what he said. That motherfucker... Set up there and said, I just might trip and sprain my ankle. The motherfucker went running on some trail or whatever and sprained his ankle.
Really? Just like he said, oh, no, man. I got to watch out for COVID. And then he ended up getting it.
Yeah. So, okay. This is a better video for you right here, though, Art, man. You could do this. I give you this idea. You could do it. You don't got to give me credit or nothing.
Go ahead.
When fucking Derek Chisora pulled out of the fight because of an injury, he called him a coward, piece of shit, all kind of fucking shit. He called fucking Derek Chisora, right? Right?
Yeah.
And then he tried to say, I'm not fighting him. That's what he said. I'm not fighting him. And that's one of my gripes that I had with Blood, because I was trying to tell Blood, this dude is not trustworthy. Tyson Fury is not a man of his word. He's a fucking liar, right? He did it with Derek Chisora. He said that he won't fight Derek Chisora because Derek Chisora had to pull out of a fight because the fight with him because he was injured. Then Frank Warren had to tell his ass, wait a minute, legally, you have to take this fucking fight, right? So then they end up having the fight, and I believe after that one, even Tyson Fury out of his own lips promised Derek Chisora a third fight.
Hmm.
Look it up. No lie.
And this is after they fought the first time.
Yes, sir.
Hmm. So he has a really extensive, man. It's like you should never be able to do something where people can really put a pattern to your bad habits. If you living like that, where people can really put a like. Man, we can connect the dots with your life like this. It lets you know that this guy is a shady guy. You know, and Dillian White says something, and I'm like, dude, I can't believe I agree with Dillian White. He said Tyson Fury's biggest skill is conning the public because they always ended up feeling bad for him. What do you think?
This is what I think about it. I don't condemn a group of people because of one person's actions or a couple of people's actions, but this dude is giving gypsies a bad motherfucking name. Whew. Ain't no way in hell you're supposed to be the king, but you always doing this damn, he's a runner, he's a track star. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's only a couple things he got to do. Man up, glove up, or shut the fuck up. And that's it. And he has, like we've been talked about, he has a history. That's what I think about that. He's everybody knows. I mean, I know we've been beating it in the bush and all that stuff, but we got to keep it up because people are still talking about Deontay Wilder and his so-called excuses like it meaning the thing. Deontay Wilder never hurt a soul besides in the ring. But, well, you could, I don't know what the thing with Mark Bonilla, I don't give a fuck. But as far as outside of that, he never hurt a soul, right? He never not gave fans fights. He never pulled out of a fight, whether that was flu, third-degree burns, or broken bones. Never pulled out of a fight. Coming into fights underweight because he was sick. You know what I'm saying? He never pulled out of a fucking fight.
Yep.
He never popped for anything, right? Mm-hmm. He never did anything outside the rules and regulations and guidelines to be called the unbecoming of a boxer, which Tyson Fury is.
Yep.
But
oh, no, Peter, hold on. Somebody in the chat sell any merch. Yeah, artmanapparel.com. artmanapparel.com. But go ahead, brother.
Yeah, you should put that in your description on your live streams.
Yeah, doing that right now.
StreamYard, you can already have it in there, so every time you go, it pops up automatically. But yeah, you know, he never did that, you know, and like Barbershop Conversations just made a video. I can't listen to it all, but because I was, you know, I'm trying to cook up, then you was live, so I was like, well, listen to him. I always go back to listen, right? He said that Edward Hearn has got to deal with Facebook or some other company. I've been telling folks, stop playing with these guys. Everybody spends money on social media, like as far as Edward Hearn and AJ.
A customer just sent money through Facebook. I was like, whoa, what the fuck? Bro, he just sent the shit. I'm like, bro, what is this?
Yeah, you can. Yeah, you sure can. Deontay Wilder is not spending money to spread propaganda. That's Edward Hearn, Matchroom Boxing, Tyson Fury. They're spending money on social media, right? For these fake accounts on Twitter, these fake accounts on social media, all through social media, spreading their shit. Now he's going to do that with Facebook. What he has to realize is that if over here, we fact check. Like, yep. We just don't, over here in America, we don't just go by what somebody's going to tell us to watch. We actually want to see it for ourselves. And he's not that man. Edward Hearn has nobody but Canelo.
And he holding on to him by hair. That interview we just seen that little screenshot of Eddie Hearn saying Canelo took the pen. Ain't that something? Like, whoa, like damn, you on record. Yeah. You on record dissing me now? You all in my face smiling?
Yeah, he said Canelo will always have an asterisk next to his name.
Woo!
That's what he said. That's what he said. And the thing about it is, see, this is the reason why you can't have Edward Hearn worse than P. Diddy. At least P. Diddy stayed the fuck out of the way when it came to other people. It's business. He always got something to say about his so-called competition. But really, to tell you the truth, they not competition. They not looking at you as competition. You looking at them as competition. You got a problem. Everybody else don't got a problem. See, the PBC is all about making their fighters money. Taking care of their fucking fighters. So at the end of the day, they don't have to be trying to take care of them, not fuck them over. Yeah, I understand that when you're in that capacity and stuff like that, can't everybody be, you know, helped out and all that stuff, right? and somebody's going to have a problem. There's too many fighters for everything to be roses, right? But let's flip over to Edward Hearn, Bob Arum, and Frank Warren. They got a whole bunch of people in the back waiting to talk shit about them. Fighters. People they did business with.
Where's
the only person I don't even got is Rick Glaser.
Where's M.O. Williams? Where is M.O. Williams?
I don't know.
Last thing I heard was a diss track talking about fuck Eddie Hearn. Bro, that's just crazy as hell. And all this shit happened during the week that Ryan Garcia said he had the mental health breakdown. But when M.O. Williams have a mental health breakdown, it's all crickets.
Yeah, I didn't believe anybody when they said that mental health thing, because, well, you know, the first guy probably who said that probably meant it, probably has some problems, right? But when it starts becoming a trend, it ain't everybody, and nobody wants to touch it. Everybody's scared to touch that shit because they're scared about getting sued. If somebody says they injured or mental health, because that's what that is, right? What can you do as a promoter? Can you force them in the ring?
That's going to be tough. I mean, you can be like, well, your contract says you got to fight two times. Man, and that's the thing with Tyson Fury, dude. Last time I checked, he has to fight two times a year. And they letting him push the fight back. Oh, man, I feel like Top Rank, they got something for Fury ass. They're going to get tired of him.
Well, that's one good thing about Bob Arum. At least Bob Arum ain't scared to tell it like it is. Like I don't see it. I don't. When he say certain things about Crawford and stuff like that, I don't think he's dogging them or whatever. But it shouldn't be said. But at the end of the day, people, if Bob Arum is going to say Tyson Fury and Crawford is costing them a lot of money, right? And he's telling everybody with Crawford, you can't make these fights with blah, 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 with the whoop, because he's in the red, blah, 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 with the whoop, with Terrence Crawford, it might be fucking true. He's probably overpaying him to keep him. But now with Tyson Fury, it's a whole nother ball game, because now this guy has to go to ESPN and then talk to them about Tyson Fury fighting him. Boom.
Mm-hmm. A guy that they just dropped a. I heard they paid, based off the documentary that they dropped in his country, they said that he inked a deal for $100 million for 5 fights.
Yeah, and he already squandered it. He already squandered some shit fighting bums.
Yep, not selling against those bums either.
And that's the reason why. And see, that's the reason why I Bob Arum said he was against it. He said it was not me. It's all Tyson Fury. It was up to me. If I was Deontay Wilder, I would sue. But then again, in America, anybody can sue, right? Yeah. And then the Saudi Arabia shit came along. I'm pretty sure at that point Bob Arum didn't give a fuck. He was like, "Yeah, if we can get this, if Deontay Wilder happens to get hurt, catch COVID, or whatever the case may be." Let's see what happens, you know, pop the PEDs, whatever. They was waiting on a Hail Mary, a prayer, that something happened with Deontay Wilder for them to get that AJ fight. Because that's the only way everybody was gonna get their money back. Straight up. Because
all that money, Tyson Fury had them in the red, so like fuck it. They like fuck
Tyson Fury wasn't getting all that money. Tyson Fury wasn't getting all that money.
That's what I'm saying. They was going to get that money. Look, I feel like they was like, fuck it, we just going to cash out on Tyson Fury's, the Saudi money, and say, fuck it, that's Tyson Fury's debt he owe us.
Yeah, what kind of businessman, what kind of great, if you call yourself this so-called big-ass motherfucking promoter and shit, what kind of big-ass motherfucking promoter is going to do this big-ass deal, right, in Saudi Arabia and not get his fucking money back. ESPN not get their fucking cut back.
That shit is just so crazy to me, the lengths that they went through to try to make this damn fight. Do you remember when Mark Kriegel was literally on ESPN and he's reading from the paper talking about some, yeah, it's been reported that each fighter is gonna get about $50 million. I'm like, bro, you really on national television capping like this?
Boy, pocket watch.
What? When did we start doing this?
thinking you about to get a cut.
That shit was just crazy. And then, you know, what blew me is how these people still have faith in Tyson Fury when he literally lied to y'all in less than 24 hours than the arbitration ruling.
Well, that shit sounds fucking wild. But what gets on my nerves is that the blatant signs right in everybody's face. You know, I understand why, you know, with the whole quote of rent-free, Deontay Wilder, mentally weak, mentally destroyed, and all that stuff. But Tyson Fury is the only one that has been showing that he is mentally compromised.
Exactly.
He can't deal with pressure. Anytime he has pressure on him, the pipes burst.
And he don't like when people tell him what to do.
Yeah. And that's fine if you don't like people telling you what to do. And you think that you could go through life and not have a boss and stuff like that. That's fine and dandy for me, if that's how you want to live your life. But don't fucking try to sell me that shit. Don't try to sell me that shit. You a slave. You a slave. All these boxers technically are slaves to the fans.
He's actually in a worse predicament than everyday people, because you owe a major company a lot of money, dude. Yeah, you could still have the lifestyle. It was good. But you are on a contract where these dudes want you to fight.
Wearing that same dirty-ass robe. Woo! He ain't watched that shit since. I bet you they walk in that hotel room, it fucking stinks.
Stinks.
Stinks like fucking ass.
Yeah.
He look like he's a stink-ass motherfucker.
He a gypsy. They used to living in the fucking fucking car.
You can live in something like that and still be clean. What I'm saying is, him particular, he looked dirty.
Man, what do you think about his father now being confident?
His father what?
Now being confident, because many believe that he's back in the UK.
Yeah. Well, he needs to be confident and fight that old man that want to bust his ass. That's been on his ass for a couple of years. If he need to be confident in himself and fight that dude, that's what his bitch ass need to do. Don't worry about your son. You fight
old dude trying to fight Big John.
Yes, yeah, it's on this dude named Porky's Corner. He got the video. They sitting in the ring in the interview. He been ducking him for years.
Ah, shit.
He been ducking that dude from years. You over here worried about your son's fight. You need to worry about the fights that's in front of you. You doing all these world tours and shit, talking about you big and bad and everything. You got a dude your age, on your helmet. You know what I'm saying? On your helmet, telling you to fight him, but you're supposed to be this big bad dude that's supposed to be exhibiting the fighting spirit of a gypsy. But when it suits you, you duck.
Because that's what they do. And that's just, bro, you know what's so crazy to me? It's like, I just asked somebody today, matter of fact. I said, so let's just say your trusted sources comes out and say that Tyson Fury cheated. Would you be surprised? Dude said no.
Who said no?
I think the dude said no. I looked at it. He either said no or he was just like, no. This is what he said. He said, I'd be surprised. But the reason why I'd be surprised, because Nevada State Commission was there.
Right? You know, they men just like they men and women just like the rest of everybody walking on this earth. Anybody can be compromised. When you see that score, that wide ass score with that wide ass score with Charlo and old boy, and you see all the other shit that's been going on. See, that's one thing. That's another thing that I keep trying to tell people. Just take the last 3 years, the last 2 years, the last 4 years, maybe even five, so they can because you don't want to keep people racing the memory. And look at the scorecards. How many elbows did Romero throw in the fucking fight? Nobody said shit.
Look. Let me tell you, that's what I said. I was telling somebody the other day, I said, man, the way Rolly was fighting, I was looking like, bro, I ain't gonna lie to you, man. He on his road to be DQ'd. But then I seen the ref face after the ref warned him like for the second time. And I'm like, dude, the ref looking like, man, this fight just need to hurry up and end. I'm not trying to disqualify this guy.
He didn't want it. People, this is what I'm trying to tell folks, man. I try to tell folks, man, ask any MMA fighter. An elbow on the forearm could do as just as much damage or more than the fucking fist. And he throwing, like Ludacris said, he was throwing bows. And he was connecting.
I said it. I said, this is motherfucking doghouse rules on national television.
Mm-hmm. And nobody, where's the videos on that? You know, if people want to come back, you know, Boston, see, because they only worried about Deontay Wilder, you, LDBC, Southern T, only worried about motherfuckers like that. They're not worried about the fucking truth. If you're worried about the truth and why the sport of boxing is the way it is, then every time you see something that's wrong, you need to stay consistent with letting it be known. You know what I'm saying? You got people out here with a million subscribers, 30,000, 100,000, 200,000, damn near half a million, and they only worried about certain people's dicks.
That's just weird, right? Ain't that weird? Anywhere about Wilder legs and shit. I'm like, bro, what the fuck? I don't know if you've seen, but I had some weird, creepy UK dude come on my fucking page.
Mm-hmm.
The fucking start twerk. I'm like, bro, what?
Mm-hmm. I saw it.
And what tripped me out the most was he was actually in the, you know how StreamYard, you can sit in the back room?
Mm-hmm.
So the whole time he's sitting in the back room, I'm thinking, okay, he even had like a regular name, like Mike's Boxing or some shit. And I'm like, okay, this motherfucker, you know, he's probably a white dude that want to talk boxing. So he was looking normal for a good 5 minutes, bro. I let him in. As soon as I let him in, he go post that weird shit. I said, bro, you got to be on some. You definitely have some type of, something's wrong with you mentally. Because why the fuck would you be that? That's just weird. Oh shit, we got a special guest in the building.
That's the reason why I don't, you know.
Yo.
What's happening?
Yo. I'm sitting here frying my chicken, listening to the art man in the background, the special guest, Michael Johnson.
What happened?
Did I hear some Rolly slander talking about his elbows?
Man, a Rolly man. I ain't gonna lie to you. That ref was looking like, man.
Hold up. You know I gotta call in and defend my boy Rolly.
Oh shit.
Them one elbows. He was just trying to put. You remember how Floyd used to push him off with the elbow a little bit, give him a little nudge, nudge.
Yeah, but he did so damn obvious. It's like, guys,
you got to do what you got to do.
We watch 4K television. We watch 4K looking like, what the fuck? Boy. And I was thinking to myself, like, man, I ain't gonna lie to you. I already know he's not gonna disqualify him, but hopefully he don't do another performance like that. Who should, matter of fact, who do y'all think he should fight next?
I say he should fight Cowboy Carl.
At 140?
Yeah.
I can see that happening.
I mean, that's a solid fight right there.
I don't think Cowboy want to take that, though. But I don't know.
He said, yeah, on Twitter. He said, yeah. I mean, shit, what else is he doing?
I mean, I think he just needs to fight somebody that's on his level. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, he needs to fight somebody on his level, you know, and not fight somebody that don't have the offensive artillery.
Who's on his level?
Well,
it has to be somebody we don't know.
I mean, who would you consider on? Yeah, who would you consider on his level?
Right.
I thought the awesome Delay fight was a good fight. If Delay didn't pull out, that's about his level, right?
What weight class he trying to fight at? 135 or 140?
He said either one.
Somebody said he should fight Gary Russell, brother.
Oh, hell no.
I said, boy, what?
Nigga, don't do it.
Shut up.
Hey, everybody better leave that boy alone.
I want to see him against, bro. I want to see him against In His Boots again in the pros.
No, I want to see him until he get up to there. I want to see him against, what's that boy named? Sabriel Matias, whatever his name is. Since they both at 140. That's what I want to see.
What y'all think about Virgil Ortiz versus Mean Machine? I said, well, what if Mean Machine pull up the upset? That shit gonna be crazy as hell.
No, he ain't gonna pull up that upset.
You don't Ortiz think so? He a big welterweight too, man.
And, Ortiz.
He did drop Bud. I ain't talking about Ortiz. I'm talking about he a big welterweight too, but I'm talking about Mean Machine. He a big welterweight too.
But you know what? The good thing about another thing though. Mean Machine grew up since he's been in America. He grew up in the RBG gym. He used to train over there.
Oh yeah.
And Mike inspired all the time. So yeah, they know him very well.
No. That's one thing I've been noticing, man. These motherfuckers show do know who the fuck to stay away from.
They be hearing about shit in sparring.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they be talking shit about
a lot of stuff. You know, these non-disclosure contracts be keeping motherfuckers quiet.
Because Mikey was the one that said, I remember I posted a video before the Bud fight. He was the one that said, Mean Machine can hit. He was like,
Really?
He sparred with him a lot. Yeah, he was like, Mean Machine can hit. I posted a video before the Bud fight. It ain't that Mean Machine was a bad fighter, it's just nobody knew him. Kind of like with Castano this past weekend.
I ain't gonna lie. I was thinking I'm gonna be 100% with y'all because I ain't gonna seem like I'm some fake ass Castano fan or anything like that. But I was like, man, I ain't gonna lie to you. I don't know who this guy is. I ain't think that he was gonna pose no type of threat to Charlo. I thought Charlo was about to walk this dude down. And then the fight happened looking like
you didn't see him. You didn't see that Laura fight?
No, I didn't. I seen the highlights and I was like, he can crack, but shit.
Yeah.
What I was thinking the whole time? I was thinking of the Rosario performance. I was thinking he was just going to do another performance like that where whenever Rosario tries to let off or Castano was going to let off, he was just going to, you know, hold him. And then as soon as they break out the clinch, just pop him like he did Rosario. You know, he made Rosario smother all of his punches.
Yeah.
And he was just working them. That's what I thought he was going to do to Castano. I didn't think he was going to be gun-shy and throwing the same 1-2.
Castano was way more seasoned. You got to realize, Castano, he came up, you know, Rosario was more like, it wasn't too much money behind him. He came up fighting. He was fighting it pro as fast as he can and just taking on any old fight, you know what I'm saying? Where Castano came up through the amateur system, quality amateur wins. You know, then he got to the pro level with some quality wins. Like one of his biggest and best wins was against Searle. Now I remember everybody saying Searle was supposed to be the next big thing at 154. At 154.
Now they don't talk about him.
And he no, because Castano beat him. And then he got to draw with Laura, which he probably really should have won. Which a win against Laura is a quality win. It's still a quality win. Ain't nobody clearly beat Laura.
What you think? Her, I think her did.
I mean, he needed that knockdown to do it. You know what I'm saying?
Nobody like schooled him like back-wise.
Yeah, nobody.
Her beat him like on some just being bigger than him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And I thought matter of fact, his fight against Lara was kind of like that fight this weekend where you could have really been like, yeah, he probably won that fight. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of motherfuckers didn't know about. You know, Mean Machine. That's how they felt about Mean Machine. Which he was a good fighter. If he had fought some other names at 147 before he fought Bud, more people would be intrigued by it. But I mean, he did lose, but got a draw against Ray Robinson.
You know who I want to see fight? I want to see my dude Jamal Shango James. I want to see somebody mix it up with.
He got a fight coming up.
He only got one loss, and guess who that's to? Yugas.
Really?
He took that fight. They say he took that fight on like 3 weeks' notice.
What a shame.
And gave Yugas a really tough fight. It's not like he went in there and got his ass kicked and he got knocked out. His only loss is to Yugas. So I'm like, okay, I want to see him up there with somebody. Win, even though he the hometown guy, win, lose, or draw, I still want to see him up there. Because he the, you know, he got the regular version of Manny Pacquiao belt.
Yeah, he about to fight he about to fight that one dude that Budev. I can't pronounce his name. One Eastern European dude. He about to fight him. That's his mandatory. Fight who? Budev, Butaev. That's his mandatory.
Huh. So when was this?
I think it's on the Spence undercard, ain't it?
Oh, well, if it's on the Spence undercard, I'll be trying to watch sometimes, man, when I'm especially when I'm off them day, I'll be trying to watch the whole damn thing, man. But it just be just too much pausing in the middle and
you be trying to watch the whole what? Undercard?
Yeah, I'll be trying to watch it all, but they just be doing all this pausing and 15 turning to 30 minutes, like, damn, where did the fight at?
Yeah, I feel you.
Like, I'll be trying my best, man, to watch it, but then wait, football and shit and driving back and forth from here to Toledo. Like, I'll be
missing, going to Toledo. Wait, hold on, you in New York, right?
No, I'm in Saginaw.
Oh, you from Sag Nasty?
Fuck no.
Why you say it like that?
Nah, I ain't from here, bro. Hell no, I'm from San Diego.
Oh,
the hell you doing in Saginaw?
Work.
Oh, okay. She is Sag Nasty.
Shit.
Matter of fact, oh boy from Sag Nasty might get that Dillian White fight.
Yeah, and I've been trying to meet up with him, but I was supposed to go to one of his workouts. I was gonna bring my little GoPro and shit, take some videos and shit.
Do that shit. Yeah. But yeah, I hope you get that fight, man. You know, I'm rolling with him. You know, I'm from Detroit. I live in Cincinnati now, but I'm from Detroit.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I just had some. My schedule was all fucked up because my teammate be working out with him. He was my teammate that played on my summer football team. You watch that thing on Showtime. He on the bridge running with him. Saginaw. So I've been trying to meet up with him, but. From what I was told, from what because I asked him to tell, I asked him something, and he got back with me with it, and he said he ready for it. Blah blah blah, whoop whoop. But I told that I tried to tell him, I was like, man, look, the nigga can't go out of the sixth round. All he got is a hook and some overhands.
I think he playing standby.
Look, if he ready for him, they not gonna make that fight.
I think Dillian.
I'm telling you, Franklin.
Hold on. Let me go off real quick. I think Dillian White is playing standby, dude. Because what if Tyson Fury don't show up?
Woo!
That don't mean he getting a Wilder fight. Y'all gotta understand, Wilder. After that shit happened with AJ, he don't fuck with Eddie Hearn like that. He just completely forgot about him. You see, he don't say shit about him no more. He don't even say shit about, you notice that?
Yep. I do notice that.
He don't fuck with them no. He don't fuck with, he ain't even worried. He's trying to do his own thing. Once he get his own thing, then he coming at them like, you know, what you want to do. If you don't want to do nothing, I can fight Andy Ruiz. I got some other fights over here.
That fight with Andy Ruiz would do so many numbers, bro. Yep. But Ruiz got to fight Ortiz.
Yeah, that'd be a good fight.
Well, so let me ask you guys this.
But hold on, let me tell you this. If Jermaine Franklin ready and he's staying ready, he might not get the fight.
Yeah, wait a minute, man. I had something to say about that too, man. You're trying to skip it. You're trying to skip us. Damn, Art. So I was talking to him and stuff like that. They really say they're ready. But like he said, that's another thing too, because he can't afford no L's. But my main thing is that even Andy Ruiz said, like, his team said they ain't seen shit. Like, but we already know Edward Hearn's MO. He just bring up shit and don't be doing nothing. He said, yeah, we're trying to make these fights, but he don't be doing no leg work. He just be doing all jaw jabbing.
Tuts, right? He be on Twitter too. Mm. He was the WBA. He was ranked in the WBA. He was supposed to fight Bivol, but Hearn kind of fucked him over. He bypassed him. He had a cut and he couldn't be ready by the date, so he had the WBA bypass him, so he didn't get his shot.
Oh man, I'd be hurt.
You know that. But that's how the game is, though, man. You know, if you got that power, that's how it is.
And one thing I asked my boy to ask me, he didn't get back with this one. Because one thing I noticed, Jermaine Franklin's gloves look kind of like extra big. Am I tripping?
You probably got some fragile hands.
Because I was looking, I was just like, God damn. But the thing about it is, in them fights that he had, what I noticed is just that he just needs some better punch placement. Like, he got it, but I think sometimes you just need to throw shorter.
So who y'all? My bad for cutting you off, bro.
I don't give a fuck.
Who do y'all think is gonna be the next heavyweight champion outside of Wilder, AJ?
Man, that's a hard one.
Nobody.
Anderson will touch them belts one day?
He ain't fought nobody yet.
No, I'm just saying not right now. I'm saying like
he could be removed. He'll be maneuvered into a position to get a belt.
I'm talking about like 5 years from now.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's four of them. And 5 years from now, AJ ain't going to have them all. So, yeah, he'll get a position to – he'll be maneuvered in position to get a belt, yeah.
Yeah.
Let me ask y'all this then.
But as far as who's the next big heavyweight American star, you talking about like that?
Fuck that question. Let me ask y'all a different question.
Hey, that's a hard one right there, boy.
Do y'all think Wilder – let's say Wilder gets past Fury – which I believe he will, strongly believe he will. Do y'all think Wilder can defend the title 10 times again against these crops of heavyweights?
Nah, he ain't going to fight enough.
You don't think so?
Nah, you remember Wilder, he was fighting 3 times a year at a certain point.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You don't think he can?
Nah, he'll be fighting 2 times a year. If he wins, he'll be fighting 2 times a year at the most.
That's gonna be tough because...
And he getting older too?
He 30. Yeah, and a lot of people will want to fight him, but some of these guys, if they management shouldn't put him in there that quick, man, because a lot of these guys they ain't got enough fights in the season to be even getting in there with that dude like that, man. You know.
I think his schedule was like after.
Okay, cool. It's possible, but I don't think after Wilder knocks out Tyson Fury, he got 10 fights in him.
Me either.
Because I'm 34, and I'm still playing semi-pro football, man. And I don't got that many years the way my body's doing. I probably got like, you know, maybe a good, if I stretch it, maybe 5. And I got to hang it up because this shit is taking a toll.
How long did it take him to defend his belt? 5 years.
Well, I mean, plus you got to understand too. Now, if he fight. Okay, let's say he beats Fury, then he fights AJ. He fight and then he fight AJ, and he beats AJ. He might be like, it ain't nothing else. He not about to be fighting no fucking any old body. You know what I'm saying?
He'd be damn near 40 too. In five years, right?
Yeah,
I don't see, like, if it goes like that, I don't see him fighting for another 3 years. Because it just ain't no heavyweights outside of him, Fury, and outside of him, outside of Wilder, Fury, Ruiz, and AJ. It ain't really no name heavyweights that's
let's say he do get the undisputed, and then let's say one of them dudes, Joe Joyce is mandatory or some shit.
Joe Joyce did this fight.
You don't think he'll fight Wilder versus Joe Joyce 2023?
Joe Joyce get, you know what? You know what? I'll put it like this: it's possible that he can get them 10 fights, right? But
that's what I'm thinking.
It's possible, but I think it's gonna be tough, in my opinion. I think it's gonna be tough to get them 10 fights after, because this year be over with, right?
He might not want them. He might not want to get our 10. You know what I'm saying?
Start in 2022. You know what I'm saying? And but you know what? These youngins just got to bust a move, and that's the reason why I like the Anderson fight. This Anderson fight that's coming up. That's a very good fight for these two for that youngin. But then you got the Coffees, you got the Michael Hunters, you got the you got Andrew Ruiz, Chris Arreola be gone because he's 40. And you got some other guys that's coming up. You got Matt Truff, you got Oscar Rivas, the other guy that kind of like he could be his brother. He just went back to MMA, I believe. But you also got this white dude coming. Forget his name. He look all right too.
Otto Wallen.
No, from here, America.
I ain't hear no white boy from here.
Yeah, he look all right. We got
you got Michael one. Coffee too.
Yeah. Then you got who fighting Brian Jennings? Oh, the Oscar Rivas. Yeah, be fighting Brian Jennings again. I thought it was somebody
ain't that a really nothing to write home about, you know what I'm saying? It's really AJ Wilder, Fury, and Ruiz.
You're correct, but what I was saying was, you know, they got to bust a move.
Ruiz.
They got to bust a move. Like, they got to.
What you say? That's that one white boy they always talking about that Hunter was going to fight, but the money wasn't right.
Mark Manoff or whatever his name.
Haverick. Some shit.
Yeah. Hooker did.
Nah, I said I think Jared Anderson will beat Ruiz.
It's possible, but not, I don't think so right now.
No, I gotta see him, man. I gotta see him. He in six rounders. I gotta see him.
Is because he's tucking his chin behind his shoulder. He's tucking his chin behind his shoulder, and
I believe in him when Top Rank put a man with a puncher.
I mean, they say even Bob Arum and Wilder fan. Not even just Wilder fans, but Bob Arum and people that know Wilder personally saying that, man, Jared Anderson putting it on Tyson Fury. Wilder side saying Jared Anderson got knocked out Fury. And then you have Bob Arum and Rick Glasher basically saying, like, yeah, they agreeing that, yeah, Jared Anderson gave Fury a hard time, but they don't want to say knock him out.
Yeah,
I can already see it now. They're going to try to promote that Jared Anderson in the future. You know how they promoted Errol Spence and said, oh, yeah, Errol Spence, you know, rumor has it that he gave, what's his name, a black eye? Floyd Mayweather, a black eye. They're going to be like, yeah, Jared
Anderson. I mean, well, shit, Kenny Porter straight up told the story.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, he ain't saying no paperwork, so. You know, but. And that's the thing, man. These guys got to bust a move. I think once they bust a move, I think we're gonna start seeing who stands out. But you know, if you really want to be, you know, you want to wear the number one headband, you know, you got to start calling these dudes out like I did in practice with these wide receivers that always want to talk shit. Told them to line it up. And that's what I think should happen. You know, if I was Jared Anderson and stuff like that, I'd be like, y'all better bring your ass. And I don't want to hear shit out of Lovejoy. That he's ass. So I'm tired of him. That's all he do. Just I'm like, your ass. You got put to sleep by a dude that ain't boxed in like fucking a decade. A mummy.
Yeah.
A dude they had to summon back from the dead. He came, he changed his name and everything and came back and whooped your ass. They just got to mix it up, man. And, you know, 5 years is a long, it's really a long time in the sport, man, for you to just be sitting around and not.
My thing is, I think what if Wilder don't take no damage like that? They saying that the brother had enough time to heal. He's feeling real good, you know what I'm saying? Healthy. All his injuries is healed up. What if he go in there and learn better skills from Malik Scott and he's knocking dudes out cleaner without taking any damage?
Yeah, I hear what you're saying, but my thing is Wilder going to be wanting to fight all them people, man?
I don't know. That's the thing. I guess it's really all up to Wilder. I'm just asking, do you think physically he can do it?
Yeah, I think physically he could do it, but the thing about it is that, you know,
I mean, because outside of Fury, AJ, and Ruiz, it ain't really no money fights.
Yeah, that too.
You know.
Yeah, that's the big thing.
If they weight up,
but Wilder could show up, put some money in their pocket though. Ain't got no problem with hooking people up.
let me ask y'all another just random question.
But so, you know what? That's what boxers used to do back in the day.
What?
When people were broken shit and stuff like that, they used to hook them up with fights.
Yeah, that's what Roy Jones did with oh boy, who was it? Mike McCallum?
No, I don't remember. Oh, he did?
Yeah, he said he fought him because he needed a payday. He said he called, they was friends. He called him like, man, I need a fight. I need some money. You know, Roy fought him. Wasn't it Mike McCallum?
Hey man, that's a cool brother then, man. Yeah. I mean, you got paid to get your ass.
Cause remember, Abel Sanchez was saying something about Roy Jones' resume or whatever, and he had fought him. He said, he fought. He was like, man, the man called me and said he needed a payday, so I gave him a fight.
Shit, I bet you Yidram like Canelo too.
And that's what Corey Spinks had a problem with Floyd about. So you ain't giving no brothers no paydays.
You know, I mean, he did for a minute, but then he got
when he got to become money man, he said it.
Well, it was the money, but he said it. He said basically like when a Mexican and a black man get in the ring, he said that's when the magic happened. That's when all the money come in.
Yeah,
it's big fight.
That's what they doing with Javante.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yep. And that's the reason why when Art said that Ruiz and Deontay Wilder is a big fight, it is because Ruiz is the one who brought people to the zone and to New York. It wasn't Anthony Joshua.
What, to New York?
Wasn't it a fight at Madison Square Garden?
Yeah, I mean,
it was at MSG. I mean,
with that fight, I feel like Eddie Hearn, he made sure his people was there, them UK people.
Oh. Yeah,
they was there. But as far as like the zone, yeah, you correct as far as the zone. But if you remember, that was after that was people that saw that fight were still on that Canelo. Whoever bought the Canelo versus Jacobs fight also got that fight with that same month.
Yep.
Okay, because that was June 1st. Okay, but if you notice, after that fight, the zone started signing a whole bunch of Mexicans after that.
Yeah,
because they got that Golden Boy deal,
you know.
Yeah,
they started signing a whole bunch of Mexicans after that.
Yeah, I'm just.
So I'm Like, I mean, yeah, they do. Fighting Mexicans do bring money, but you know, two brothers will bring money too. You know, niggas just gotta they don't be trusting them for some reason.
Man, if I was Bernard, man, and I'd have been like, man, Oscar, man, you step to the side for a minute. You just go party and let me run this shit, man. Like, fuck. He fucked it up. Ooh, he fucked some money up.
Who, Oscar?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, yeah, he did.
Fuck.
But nigga, it's I feel like it's a little bit of Bernard Hopkins' fault too, because why are you just sitting there, dude?
Well,
I think because he more just like an employee. I don't think he really, you know, because Oscar's best friend really run the company, Eric Gomez.
Yeah.
He really run the company. Bernard is more like a face, you know.
Went out there and got his degrees and shit.
Yeah, more of a face. But yeah, Oscar, they could have, man, they would have took the game over. If they would have stuck with Oscar and Schaefer and Heyman like they had it, man, bruh.
They had all the good black talent.
Yeah, they would have took the game over.
No, they did.
But you remember what AB said, though? He said that Oscar De La Hoya brought him in to lose to the Mexican fighter.
That's what, didn't Jermell Charlo say that, too?
I don't know.
Something similar?
I think he said something about it. He was not trying to give him no opportunities.
Yeah. And look at old boy, Rashid Ellis.
Who is that?
No, I mean, whatever.
Shit. They doing that nigga bogus as hell, putting him on the shelf. Look at his brother.
He should have just stayed the face of the company. Everybody know Oscar. Everybody know Golden Boy. He was good. You know, it's just the face of the company. Go out to the press conferences. Let the other people handle the business. You go out to the press conferences. You do the talking. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what you're good at. But when he got out of rehab, he felt like he wanted to run his company his way. Like you ever, you know, like my father, he was on drugs bad. And every time he get out of prison and get clean, he come out, he want to take over the world and
change
and
his life.
Yeah.
Then go revert back to the same shit after a while.
Yep. Yep.
When shit don't work out. When shit hit the fan.
Just start getting tough.
That's the same shit with Oscar.
But, yeah, and I think you're absolutely right.
That shit so well, nigga. Damn.
He ain't learned his lesson, boy. That boy can lose some money. How you lose Canelo? Motherfucker.
Ah. You know, Dante said some shit today. He said more and more shit about to come out from Oscar about how he really feel about Canelo. And how I feel like he says he feels like there's some stuff that's hidden that he just kept to the side. What if he started talking about that funeral stuff? Like, really say, like, man, I had to do this and that. I had to hide. I had to pay. You know, what if he started talking like that?
I don't think Oscar know nothing about that, though. Because it's really, even at Golden Boy, is really, when Canelo was a Golden Boy, is really Canelo and his manager, trainer, and Reynoso. Oscar knew it was just a business. Like he said, they really didn't talk like that. You know, Oscar don't know what they got going on, what the Reynosos got going on. I would be saying, they in Mexico. Oscar live in America.
Canelo was talking about Oscar not loyal, but I'm thinking to myself, like, dude, what? You put a stain on his company by being his biggest star and popping for pegs. That's wild. Like, what? You basically, you kind of like my employee and look what the fuck you put. I got to, you know, pretend like this shit ain't foul. You know, what do y'all think about that?
And motherfucker ain't loyal. He ain't loyal, but it's a faction. It's a business, but then there's a faction within it. Like he said, like Oscar probably didn't know he was juicing. Oscar probably thought he was a stand up guy. He never popped before, right?
And that ain't Oscar's business. You know, honestly,
yeah.
I mean, I feel like. It is his business because he's just. That's his
I know. Yeah. I mean, yeah, and that's in that aspect. Yeah, no, but, business, but he don't. He's not in the know what the dude be doing.
No, but you see, promoter, and fighter, they got that. That's not an employee-employer relationship.
That's what I'm.
That's a contractor. Like that. You know, that's a contractor relationship.
If you're a business, well, his business partners, are you dealing business with somebody in that aspect?
Yeah.
But you know. It's not like he's going around making him piss in the cup and doing his own ear analysis. You know what I'm saying? So the way I put it is that, you know, it's good for him. Canelo went that way, but it sure enough didn't look good. And you know, if Oscar probably wrote a book, people would look at him different in a different light with all his sexual deviant escapades. But when it, I know, right?
But what
I mean, Oscar ain't 100% clean himself. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
He got some demons with them, with them, with them teenage girls down in Mexico, and all that money he paid had that shit shut up, hush. You know,
probably still.
He really ain't want to be talking about nothing. Oscar better keep his mouth shut.
Oh yeah, well that's that's about right. He can't write a book.
Yeah, you better keep his mouth shut. There's a lot of shit on him. Aram is the one shit that used to cover all the, up all that shit for Oscar.
So he was doing what now? Y'all put me on some game.
Yeah, he had settled. He paid a settlement for statutory rape.
Yeah, ooh. Aram know all that shit.
What? Yeah.
Aram, look, the dude was boxing and being in a druggie at the same time.
Yeah, he was out of control. Oscar was out. If it was nowadays with social media, he'd have been done. He'd have been done for the shit he was doing.
Like, he go around doing that shit like he got problems. Like, somebody did something to him, like mentally or physically or something. Because no way in hell I'm showing up to Triller as representing my company. You know what I'm saying? Looking like that. That wasn't no damn weed. Yeah, I can see you smoking some weed, but that was not fucking weed.
Yeah. Oscar got demons. He got demons. You never know. You remember he lost his mother young. You never know what. His mother died of cancer when he was a teenager. So you know, you never know. And then being in that Olympic program, you know, it's a lot of predators and shit like that working with these kids.
Uh-huh.
You know, trying to make it seem like that gymnastics teacher that was at Michigan State.
Woo!
You know, it'd be a lot of predators be working with these kids, man. You got to be real careful.
So he had free reign for years.
Yep.
Wow.
He ain't lying. And even with the Olympics, they be catching him like years later, like decades later,
but they always knew, but they ain't want to make the spotlight.
Somebody knows. Somebody always knows.
Of course, somebody know.
But if you having success, motherfuckers don't want to say shit.
Yeah. Ain't that how the game go? Shit.
Yeah, Tyson Fury.
Yeah. Man, I just feel like he got paid media behind him, dude.
You remember the steroids in baseball?
Shit.
Motherfuckers weren't trying to, man, all that money was coming in. Wasn't nobody trying to hear that shit.
You're right. Until the government game came in.
Yeah.
There was nobody. They was
going, you remember that's when baseball was coming off that strike and attendance was low. But them niggas started hitting the home runs and everybody went crazy. Everybody started going to games. Everybody was talking about baseball again.
And nobody was stopping them from taking it.
No, they knew what was going on, but too much money was coming in.
Man, somebody told me.
But like you said, you feel like Fury got paid media. It ain't really necessary paid media. But if you notice it, this is what I'm starting to notice. Is Southern T still in here? You still in here, Southern T? Excuse me. But I'm starting to notice a lot of people, Southern T, he made a good point when he had Jake on the show the other week. He talked about how he became a Wilder fan, and he talked about basically like his experience with the media in general. Cause me, like I became a Wilder fan after that Pavetka shit. I'm like, hold up, why are they doing this brother like that? Let me see what's really going on. You know what I'm saying? Mm. They was trying to make it seem like Wilder was the one in the wrong for not fighting him after he popped dirty twice.
I'm telling you,
but Southern T said he had a similar story where I think he said he became more of a Wilder fan after the I forgot what he said, but man, you got to check out his interview. And he was talking about like how he would read something and he wasn't really understanding why everything was so negative, but he'd read Jake's story and it'd be more even, more fair. You know, he said he wasn't. Then he started paying attention to who's actually writing the story and started differentiating between writers. This writer got this bias, that writer got that bias. But so what I noticed is a lot of guys starting to wake up and see that there is, it is a lot of bias, and they taking it upon themselves to educate their own selves. And even start their own channels like you, like Southern T, like Michael, you got your own channel to push your own stories.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because y'all can reach as many people as, I mean, Coppinger worked for ESPN, so he got a big audience. But these other guys, y'all can reach as many people as they do. Shit, through social media, through YouTube, through Instagram.
Trust me, I see it, brother. I see it.
I just believe they paying these guys. I mean, whether that's these fake accounts on Twitter. I'm telling you from experience that I've seen with politics, and that I've seen with how propaganda gets disseminated. It gets disseminated, even some of these corporations buy fake social media accounts. New York tried to outlaw it to where you can pay in for subs and shit like that to spread information.
It's like this as well.
But I understand what you're saying, Mike, and I agree that does happen. But can you think of any when stuff like that happens? Can you think of any influential accounts? Excuse me, accounts that's influential that'd be worth paying. Not somebody with like 50 followers that just be coming in and trolling, but that's actually moving the conversation to a different.
Well, I don't think they were having I know them when I see them, but I don't like take count of them or anything. I don't write it down and stuff like that. It's like Boxing Kingdom. Like, take for instance, these guys, right? Listen to what they say. It's UK Matchroom Boxing orientated.
Right? Boxing Kingdom?
Yeah, King Gom, not Kingdom, King Gom or something. It doesn't say Kingdom. It's purposely misspelled.
Yeah.
And then when you go around, you look at their videos, you look at this. I'll give you a prime example. Alexander Povetkin, right? I still have the court case on PDF. I read that motherfucker. And that shit is in detail, and none of these motherfuckers knew what the fuck they was talking about. Wilder didn't have to show up over there because he already popped, and Wilder was going to be on time. I think it's like he had to be there 2 weeks before the fight or something like that. These guys were saying that he jumped Chevy, didn't want the fight, left, even though they knew that the fight couldn't happen because Alexander Povetkin was deemed suspended.
Yes.
These guys don't know.
The WBC wasn't going to sanction it, number one.
Exactly. And a lot of these channels out here, they kept saying the same shit, and it just over and over again, all of them. Whether or not it was Sean Newton, Sporting Dick and Booty Icons, whoever, they were all saying the same shit. Listen to how somebody says something, and then all of a sudden it starts getting repeated, and it goes down the food chain.
Yep.
Over and over again. It's like, as soon as somebody plants a seed negative on PBC, Deontay Wilder, Errol Spence, whoever, who's ever on the opposite side of Matchroom Boxing or UK in general, it starts a seed, and that seed, that one little seed gets planted, and it just trickles on down. Somebody getting paid. Sporting Icons admitted. Look how Coogan Cassius came in the game. They've been paying him for years.
Yep.
It's 78 Sports said it. He said, man, them folks approached me with it to start talking crazy about Wilder.
Yeah, anybody with a following is gonna get approached. Anybody with a following will get approached. It's about if you want to take the money or not. You know what I'm saying? But anybody with a following and with influence is going to get approached.
Yep.
I'd rather make my 78. I'd rather make my money on my own rather than not end up like Nestor Gibbs and have my own video taken down.
Right. Like, what the fuck? Hell no.
Trust me, I'm not good at working for people, number one. I ain't had me a job in over motherfucking 10 years. I ain't worked for nobody in about 10 motherfucking years. I've been on my own since.
That's what I'm talking about. Shout out to you,
brother. I can't just do. I don't know. I like to say shit without repercussions. You know what I'm saying?
Yo,
you know, I ain't the type of motherfucker to be calling me talking about we need to have a meeting. Nah, nigga, no, we don't. That ain't even in my repertoire. But unless I'm getting paid for it, you gonna pay me for my time, then I'll talk to you. But you know, but yeah, there's a lot of motherfuckers getting paid. I tell you, even that Michael Benson account.
Of course.
Oh yeah,
man. And you want to know how I got all these UK haters? Because I purposely put the bell notification on Mike Benson post whenever he talked about AJ Fury, and I just drop facts on his. I'd be the first nigga to drop some shit. I'd be like, hell no, that fight ain't happening. I'd be the very first one on that shit in the UK, motherfuckers. The whole thread be about them just hating on me, saying, oh, you don't know what you talk about. You don't know what you talk about. But yeah, fuck, dude. That's what I'm like, yeah. You know,
and the thing about that, which is so crazy to me, which is just blows my mind when I think about it, and I think about it, and I think about it. What? Nobody could say, I mean, even this even goes for Wilder's side, but more so for Fury, Hearn, Aram, and all them. You don't know what a judge or arbitrator is going to rule. I mean, I can understand why Wilder's side was confident because they knew their case was tight. But for people to be out here like Hearn and Aram, you're talking about, yeah, the fight is done, the fight, that's like a slap in the face to the judge, really.
It is. I don't know if you've been following me on Twitter that long, but that was one of the very first few things I said. I said, dude, how do you think this looks to the judge? You talking about holding a fight? And then, I did my own independent research because I always knew that the judge was going to rule in Wilder's favor because ESPN has it documented the reason why the fight was pushed back. Yeah. It's like you had it right and you knew the obligation.
The reason the fight was pushed back is because Aram didn't want to put – Aram was responsible for putting on that fight. Excuse me. Coppinger, exactly. he let it slip in an interview. I cannot find that tweet. I made a tweet about it.
I know an interview.
A while ago, he said Top Rank kind of screwed PBC because they didn't put on the fight. You know, they were the lead promoter on the rematch.
It was on IFL TV, bro. I posted on okay. That whole thing.
And so you basically kind of knew, like, hold up. You know, the truth trickled out a little bit. Basically, they didn't want to lose money on the fight, so they just stalled it out, then said, oh, the contract has expired.
Well, this is one of my things, too, is like, they tried to say...
Hold on. One more thing, Mike. Let me finish this off. Like you were saying, how seed is planted and it spreads. So what seed was planted then? Wilder didn't want to fight.
Oh.
That was the seed that was planted. Wilder didn't want to fight. Wilder was quiet. He never said nothing. The nigga, he exercises rematch clause. Once you do that, he ain't got to say shit. He didn't really want. I mean, I kept hearing that
and then Top Rank and Bob Arum and Tyson Fury, they went along with that same narrative. Oh, we ain't heard from him, and this and the third, which they fucking did.
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah. He said we hadn't heard from him, and really, Mike Coppinger let it slip. He said they were working together. Then PBC didn't hear from Aram them. And then all of a sudden they said the contract expired.
But let me say this. Right. This is the part that you know, people make all types of videos about other people in their channels and shit like this. Bob Arum was happy that this arbitrator was the judge. Bob Arum already had dealings that ruled in his favor with the same arbitrator. People didn't do their research on this arbitrator.
I was nervous at first. I ain't gonna lie to y'all.
And when you look this dude up, he's a world-renowned arbitrator. People look up to this dude. He holds organizations for arbitration. This dude is not no... He won awards, multiple awards. He got accolades. He's a trendsetter. And when it comes to arbitrating, and these guys, you got people out here saying they don't believe what the fuck he's saying. They think that he's a sham and he's this and the third, but didn't look at the dude's body of work. The dude is a beast. Yeah. And like you said, Art, man, these dudes, they act like they was going up. And then, you know, another thing is, the other seed they tried to plant was that arbitration and mediation didn't mean anything.
Yeah. Yeah. He can't force Fury to fight. That was another thing. I'm like, dog, y'all don't know what the fuck
like, I'm talking about. Like, people are telling me, like, man, there's no way a judge can tell Fury he has to fight Wilder. And this, bro, what?
And this he'll is just give him, he'll just give him some money. He'll just give him some money.
Give him some money. Yeah.
Like, this is the same arbitrator that Bob Arum. See, this is why they didn't do their research, they dumbasses. This is the same arbitrator because they won't talk about this. Because this is the same arbitrator that ruled with the drug test for Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. And this is the same arbitrator that got Donair to get back with Top Rank because he tried to run. So, you know, let's not act like this dude's first rodeo when it comes to arbitration in boxing. You know, not y'all, but you know, y'all know what I mean.
I heard that he was heavily influenced by the Lewis Rockman case.
It could be possible because
I heard that he also was influenced by he believed that Tyson Fury did cheat. Yep. Because look at his history. They said they put up a lot of his history as well. You know, this case, I can't wait to go public. I cannot wait. Because when it does, a lot of stuff is going to come out. They said Tyson Fury.
It might not go public, though. I mean, those don't have to go public.
Shit. You don't think it's going to go public?
Nah.
10 years from now?
Nah. They could have a confidentiality agreement.
Oh, yeah, they probably could. You're right.
I'm pretty sure because it was a gag order, so I'm pretty sure they got a confidentiality. Cause I had a settlement I can't talk about to this day, even though the money been paid out, shit like that. You know, I can't disclose the terms of the settlement.
Yep. It is what it is. But I'm about to wrap this up, man. I got to put more hours into this picture. Get one final look before I close the show. You want to let people know where they can find you?
Oh, Mike dropped off. I know. Nah, these motherfuckers don't need to know where to find me. I be tired of talking to these motherfuckers. I just be ignoring them.
They gonna pull up on your ass, shit.
Hey, you can find me at the Jake Paul fight in Cleveland. Come say what up.
Bet. All right, brother. Y'all stay safe. Artman Apparel.